top-level show jumping. Such performances depend on many different factors. An essential one is course design, and this applies not only as here in a competition, but also in training. Course design is a creative and aesthetic job, as well as a practical craft, which at the end of the day makes the difference between success or lack of it in show jumping competitions. Olaf Petersen is one of the most successful show jumping course designers in the world. Course design for him can be classified into three sections. First, the distances between the fences. Second, the track to be ridden. Third, the design of the fences. A rule of thumb for all fences, the higher they are, the more precisely the takeoff spot has to be calculated. In the case of a vertical like this one, it would be about 1.9 meters before the fence and landing point, then about 2.6 meters behind it. Here again we have a comparison of the described types of fences and how the horse jumps them. It's very important to understand these before progressing to the next chapter, combinations. Just to recapitulate, landing after a vertical approximately 2.6 meters, then one normal stride, 3.5 meters, take off approximately 1.6 meters before the oxer. The ideal distance between the vertical and the oxer in this sequence is therefore around 7.7 meters. It's not a question here of the heights and widths, but rather of the distances between the fences. Modern technical courses place demands on the riders and horses by means of the distances. The riders are forced to think carefully. Here we have a distance from a vertical to a Liverpool. The distance is 18.3 meters. In other words, four strides which have to be developed forwards. The normal landing point is here. One, two, three, first stride. One, two, three, four, second stride. One, two, three, four, third stride. One, two, three, four, fourth stride. So it's approximately 2 meters from here to the oxer, providing I ride normally with four strides and do nothing, don't give any leg aids, I come at a bad distance. I've thought about this problem a lot, and in the end I've decided in favor of measuring out the distance, of striding it out from pole to pole, because then I know and can feel a bit more precisely what my horse and I really have to jump over. I've often practiced doing this at home, so as to develop the certainty in my subconscious of what really was a 1 meter stride. After a few months, I really knew how I had to stride in order to have reliable meter-long steps. Yes, this distance isn't so easy either. Here are five fluent strides. Indeed, quite doable from a distance point of view. Or otherwise do six. But these would have to be a bit shorter. But here it's a combination with two strides, where it would be recommendable to come in well collected and decisively. So here it's really a fairly technical exercise to jump the vertical slowly, to wait a moment, six strides, and then here to be well prepared to jump the combination. Now in slow motion, so that you can count two. The problem is solved exactly as he said it would be. Even if you never ride such a horse, and are probably just as unlike ever to design such a course, there is a lot which you can learn here, even if your course is only 1.2 meters high.